I stayed home with the boys. I raised the kids. You know, I did the
What did he want you to do?
Shut up.
Why didn't you do that?
Honestly, hindsight is 20/20. I don't know why I didn't do that.
What's up, YouTube? It is your boy once again with another episode of Foolery. So let's jump right in this, man. Let's jump into this. How many of you guys out there had a woman so bad that you would just rather, like, no matter what, get up out of there? This guy, his woman was so bad. She admitted she's a handful, her mouth. So bad that he just had to go. And now, after 5 years of her realizing it was her, she's mad that he won't come back. Ain't that some shit? But this is where we at with this story here, man. So this woman ruined her marriage, messed up relationship with the father and the two sons, and because she would not take accountability. And we've seen this over and over and over. But right now, we're going to see it and listen to this woman who just don't get it. She just don't get it. But the Godfather going to talk to her. So let's jump right in here. Y'all make sure y'all hit that subscribe, like, and share. And definitely hit that notification to catch the next video that I drop. So let's get it, man. Let's get it.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm fine. Can I not be on camera?
No.
Well, it's fine. It's fine.
You gotta be on Instagram. Okay. How old are you?
I am 37.
All right, what's the question or the comment?
Your question was, am I...
Yeah, what are y'all holding out for?
Party of one?
Yeah, what are women holding out for?
I don't know. I was married and divorced. I didn't hold out, but I wouldn't say that I'm holding out today. I just, after listening to you, I don't see any hope in anything.
What do you mean?
I mean, I don't know. I feel like my market value is not as high as it used to be prior to marriage. I have two children. I'm divorced.
It's not as high as it used to be?
Yeah.
Well, that's, I mean, anything that ages and gets used decreases. So, I mean, that's expected though, right?
Correct.
Okay, go ahead.
Expected though. So,
What'd you say?
I said divorce wasn't expected. So I wasn't, you know, planning on the decline. But, I guess I'm a party of one now, and I don't know, like, how it works or when.
Who filed for divorce?
My husband did.
Why'd you guys split?
Because I didn't know how to be a wife.
Okay.
I wasn't taught.
Okay. So is that a more accurate reason why you feel like there's no hope?
Yeah.
So it's not the declining sexual marketplace value or the divorce, it's you.
I think it's a combination. I mean, now that I'm learning, I mean, I've learned a lot since the divorce.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like with the knowledge that I have, I don't know if there's anything out there that would accommodate.
Anything out there that what?
Anything that would accommodate my situation. I mean, you know, who wants to take care of someone else's kids?
See, this is the sad part about this in these relationships. These women don't think about what it would be like without him. They just know that he's in front of me and I'm going to attack him with my tongue 24/7 and he better sit there and take it. But when the brother gets up and bounce, you have to sit there now like, nobody else wants to put up with this. But it takes that to happen before you realize how jacked up you are. That's the crazy thing. A lot of you ladies, y'all mouth is terrible, man. I mean, terrible. And men is finally wising up and realizing, I don't have to be here. I don't have to put up with it, and I don't have to be here. Peace. That's all I can say, ladies. Pay attention to what you have at the house.
And, Do
Eric says to Mary.
no. Probably watching.
Then why not go back to him?
I've tried. He doesn't work.
Why do you think that is?
I don't think he's seen a change in me.
What's the name of your therapist?
Kevin Samuels. No, I'm just kidding. I don't have one.
You know what that is?
What's that?
The world's smallest violin playing My Heart Bleeds for You. I mean, what do you want us to say, ma'am? I mean, you're married. You honest and said he divorced me because I didn't know how to be a husband. But then you go to the market and say, I don't think there's any hope because of declining sexual marketplace value. That happens for everybody, for all women. In particular, it doesn't necessarily happen for all men, but yeah, our value decreases too. But then you don't know anybody who will accommodate your situation. Yeah, the man you started your situation with. But why doesn't he want you back? Because you ain't done nothing.
You see, in this case, this woman thinks she's healed because she learned her lesson. You learned a lesson, all right, that grown people don't have to put up with your crap. Your behavior is so bad that nobody wants to put up with you. And you think it's a joke. You laughing, you hee-hee and making all these gestures, but something ain't right up there. Y'all got to get this, ladies, y'all got to get in counseling. Stop trying to self-counsel yourself or self-heal and all this stuff that you ladies say y'all doing out here. I'm self-healing. I'm healing. All right, what's your therapist's name? I don't have one. When did we start fixing ourselves? If my car gets so much damage, I can't fix it. I take it to a mechanic. Same thing. Go get help, man. Stop all this.
I think I mean, I have gone to therapy. I'm not in active therapy, but I
How
think
long? What's the longest continuous time you've been in therapy?
so during the marriage, closest to the divorce, I was in therapy for the last 2 years trying to, rectify the marriage.
No, you one-on-one by yourself.
I was alone with that. I was alone in that.
So
I
when you were in your marriage, you were
correct.
doing therapy by yourself?
Correct. When I saw things were going, hectic, I knew that I was doing something wrong. I knew that I had a part to play, and I sought therapy. And the therapist kept telling me to get a divorce, and I didn't like that idea.
Was your therapist male or female?
A female. Yeah.
Isn't this wild? You go to a therapist, you don't bring your husband. You know for yourself that the cause of everything is you, but your therapist still telling you to divorce him? See, you're not telling that story to your therapist, right? It can't be, and she's still telling you to divorce your husband. And see, that's why I don't like dealing with like female therapists and all this stuff, because they can have something happen in their past and they will make it connect to something personally. Man just broke up with her. So now she know what it feels like to be hurt like this and all this. So you start talking about it. Now she's all, I know what you feel like. I went through it. Let's get through it together. And there you go. You shouldn't be with him. I left mine. I didn't put up with it. That's how the shit goes. That's why you asked that female therapist, right? Okay. Operating out of emotions. Gots to be more careful, guys. Gots to be careful. I don't want no female therapist.
To the church.
Huh?
I went to the church after that and sought the therapy through like counsel through the church, like through ministerial counsel and stuff. That worked out a little better, but by then it was just too late. I didn't actually, go through with full therapy. He had already too much water was under the bridge and it was already over.
What do you mean it was already over?
I guess he had already had enough of everything. I mean, I stayed home with the boys. I raised the kids. I did the
What did
wife.
he want you to do?
Shut up.
Why didn't you do that?
Honestly, hindsight is 2020. I don't know why I didn't do that. At the time, I didn't know why. I mean, now, looking back, I was stupid. I was angry. I didn't read all the stuff that I read now, and I've been like hooked on Shahrazad Ali for the last 5 years, and you, and a lot of other, people that talk about these types of things and the anger inside of us at times that we get from our moms and their anger. So I learned a lot, but
Right.
when it was time to get him back, I mean, it was, it's been too long. It's been 5 years. He's in and out of different relationships, and then of course the divorce battle, right? That was a problem.
See, the thing with this is she basically went to the therapist, but it was already too late. That's what then happened here. She goes to the therapist to try to fix something. You didn't take the husband, so basically, all she got to go on is what you tell her. Like a while back, she was saying like the therapist told her to get a divorce. So I wonder, like, why would she tell you that? But you saying it's your fault because of your mouth. So she's trying to BS Kevin right now with this story because it ain't making sense. It ain't making no kind of sense, man. Y'all ladies be sitting out here doing this stuff. Y'all ruin your family. Then you try to figure out a way to still 5 years later make it seem like, well, I may have messed up, but he should have come back when I realized it. Like, who does that? I mean, let's just be real. Nobody do that.
Is it he's gone on, or you haven't done enough work?
I maybe both, but I've been trying. I mean, I've spent 5 years. I haven't moved on. And the thing is, I'm scared of the market, right? So I'm scared to. I haven't gone back because I don't think that there's anything out there. I believe in marriage. I believe in the
Well, the
oneness.
market's out there. The market's out there, but the market's going to ask the same questions I'm asking.
I don't
What
know.
do you think you were going to get? I mean, when you're in your marriage and being the way you were, what were you fighting for?
You know what? I don't know. I just saw my mom do it. I did what I saw her do.
Your mom was married?
No, she just fought with all of her boyfriends and fought with us. And I of
Who has
course,
custody of the boys?
I do.
How old is the youngest?
Eight.
Y'all notice how nonchalant she said how her mother's behavior is? You know, she said she just watched her mom fuss with all her boyfriends and all this and this and that them. So now she picked it up. Like I always said, it's a learned behavior. These girls don't just get this from nowhere. They getting it from their mothers. And when they get in a relationship, they're gonna do the same thing. So just imagine the dude is out the house and she's there with the two boys. So guess who's catching the lip now? Right, the two boys. She probably taking out everything about what's going on with this father on her boys. So when these boys get of age, she already got them trying to turn against the boy because she keeps saying little stuff like, oh, they're good. They don't miss him. They don't do this. How do you know this? They might just be angry because they don't understand. Like, why would he leave? But he had to leave because she was about to just drive him crazy. So it ain't worth it for him to be in the home. I mean, that's just where it is. I know a lot of you is like, well, I would never leave my kids. You can't never say never because you've never been there. Me and my partner just had a conversation about that. Don't ever say never because you've never been there. So you don't know. You don't know what it's like to have a woman like this that, and she even say her mouth is her problem. A lot of dudes ain't never had women like that, and they end up with one they marry and don't know what to do. So this is a whole different thing, man. Everybody don't grow up like that. I'm sorry to tell you. Just don't.
In at all.
Why?
He says he's not financially stable. to see them or take them because I take all his money after the divorce. So he blames me for that. But I offer, I ask, I beg him.
Hold on.
I mean, he doesn't.
What state are you in?
Pennsylvania.
Do you get child support?
I do.
Cut off the child support.
How will I be able to help take care of the kids?
See?
I need that.
Okay, cut off the child support and have actual joint custody with your ex-husband.
So wait a minute. You'd mean to tell me you've been divorced 5 years. Your kids are in school. You still don't work. You're relying on the child support to live off. And when he asks you to make it, then you worry about being alone. But when he asks you to basically cut the child support by doing joint custody, you can't do that. And see, guys, this is that thing where it goes, well, if he come back, then I'd stop. You see what I'm saying? That's what she wants. She wants him to come back, then she'll drop everything. But you noted that it was your fault that he left. You hadn't shown him, you hadn't gone no counseling, no real therapy. And if you did, you didn't stay in it long enough. You think you healed, but evidently you're not because you're still trying to give it to him. You sitting here laughing at, oh, he on somebody's couch. He dating multiple women. He doing this, doing that. But guess what? You ran him out the house. You can't control what he do outside the house and inside the house. And now you just done made a mess and you don't know what to do because nobody else want you. Let's just be real. Everybody think you're probably crazy. And you're lazy. So it is on this, on that. She's just going to be by her damn self. And them kids going to grow up. And them boys going to grow up and get up out that house.
Straight up joint. 3.5 days with you or 4 days with you. 3 days with him. 3 days with you. 4 days with him. No child support. Listen. That would send a damn sure close signal that you're on trying to actually do something different. It would also give your boys more time with the man they need to be with, their father. If he's saying the money is draining him, well, man, cut the child support off. Move in good faith. How will it hurt your boys if you cut child support and you actually have joint physical custody with their father? To where now the reason for the money is gone because he has to pay for them when they're with him. You have to pay for them when they're with you. So there's no need for the money. How does it hurt the boys?
I understand what you're saying. It doesn't hurt them at all. But what if he doesn't have a place to live, where would he take them half of the time?
So he lives in his car?
He lives on somebody's couch.
This woman here is full of dog poop, man. Number dog poop. She's sitting there now saying all this little stuff like, so where would he take the kids? You know he's not living on the streets. But see, what you don't want to say is, he ain't taking my kids to some other woman's house. Right? You say one thing, you don't know where he's living, he's sleeping on somebody's couch. What the? You know, it don't make sense, man. It's just that you want to stick it to him because he won't come back to you. But you're going to hurt your boys doing it. And you think you're hurting him. Yeah, he's hurt. But then you're draining him. So his pockets ain't right. But he'll get back right. But the boys' damage going to be done. And you ladies love doing this, thinking y'all doing something. Then when that boy turned 18, you kind of just turn him loose. And then you want to put everything. When he start acting up, all of a sudden, where their dad didn't spend no time with him. Well, he don't get to spend no time with them because he can't get past you. This is why. Because you constantly running to court and saying this and saying that. So he got to stay away from the house because you probably run and threaten to make charges on him. Let's just be real. So you ladies do it to your kids. That's all I can say. With all this shit here, this is what keeps men from coming back around, even though they got kids with you. It's just not worth it for them. They'll wait this kid try to grow up or something and try again, but they're not going to keep going back and forth with you. They're not going to do it.
Are you getting child support every month?
Yeah.
So he's on somebody's couch.
I didn't ask him to do that.
I didn't say you asked him to do it, but I just want you to understand that from the man's standpoint, ain't nobody gonna have shed one tear. Because you were with a man and you said it. And now after the marriage, you getting the money. And I don't wanna get too deep into it, but what's more important, having a functioning relationship with your ex and having your boys with their father and having some semblance of a family, or this cold war?
I just feel like, Kevin, I didn't ask for any. I begged him to stay. I promised I went to therapy.
No. See, you can beg him to stay. But I asked you the first thing, what was the name of your therapist? And the problem is he hasn't seen enough change. Let's just imagine this happens. Let me use my Thanos powers here, shall we? Let me use my Thanos powers. Hello, Eric. Hey. This is me. Yeah. You know, I want to do something. The boys don't see you that often, and I know you're in this way, and you say it's on me because I get the money. So here's what I want to do. I went down to the court and I actually terminated the support order. I terminated the support order, and I want to have joint physical custody with the boys. I give you about 90 days to get yourself together to where you have a place to where the boys can come over there. So you should be able to do that with the money you get. There's videos on YouTube right here with women who have cut off the child support and been helpful to the ex-husband, and now they're in a better position. How does that hurt the boys?
It doesn't hurt them at all, Kevin.
So do you not think if you cut the support off, what do you think he would do?
I think he wouldn't. I think the number would change.
So you think if you cut the child support that he would not see the boys?
Correct. We were separated for 5 years and three.
Okay. So let me stop you right here. I want you to stop you right here.
Yes, sir.
You want to get back with the man who you said if you cut the child support off, how you keep the money and still not see the boys?
Correct.
So why you want to get back with a man with such a low character? If that's what you really believe.
I literally believed in the sanctity of marriage.
That's not what I asked. I asked, why would you want to get back with a man? Because, see, there's fear here. And I'm trying to understand why you want to go back to this man. If you're saying, I'm dealing with a man, if I cut the child support off and offer him joint custody, he'd just take the money and still be out of his boy's life. You don't think very highly of him.
I don't. But
Now make it make sense. Make it make sense. Make it make sense. You sitting up here for what statement going about 15 minutes saying how you want this man to come back. You want to do all this stuff. You want to try to get yourself. You know you was the problem. You're taking accountability for it. Blah, 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 blah. But then you're going to say he ain't no good, really. Why would you want him back if he's such a bad person? Why? You see what I'm saying? She can't right now get past that she still is an angry woman. That's why he's not coming back. He probably done did this and came back and forth so many times. And this last time he's like, know what? I'm not coming back. And so when he didn't actually come back, that's when she probably started, okay, it done got real now. Well, I'm going to put you on child support. Go ahead. I don't care. Put me on child support. So she do that. He still ain't coming around. Now you're keeping the boys from him and saying, they good, they good. How are they going, they're two boys without their father and you saying they're good when the father used to be in the home. And see, you probably run around that house. We all know you run around that house talking about what the daddy ain't did. Well, your daddy ain't do this. Your daddy worrying about these other women out here. Your daddy ain't this. Mama got you. Don't worry. Mama going to do it. Mama going to make care. If I had to work 19 jobs, which she does not, because she does not work. So she's sitting there, sitting her ass on the system, talking shit about this dude and what he got going on. He going to get back right. He just made sure she don't know what he's doing now. Because as soon as she find out he has a good job, guess what you think she going to do? Run back up there and try to get more money off him. That's why he making sure she don't know where the hell he's at. Got to be more careful out there. But this chick is bona fide crazy. Bona fide crazy. But she's a little bit more.
I still love him. I mean, I'm married. And like, I think that that means something. I mean, I love my brother. He may not be the best person in the world, but I love him.
Did you hear what you just said? And I want you to think about what I'm about to say. Mm-hmm. You're in charge of raising two boys? And you don't think very highly of their father.
I don't tell them that.
Do you know when your children are sick, even without them telling you? Do you know when something's wrong with one of your children just by looking at them?
Yeah.
Why? Because you raise them and they're around you. Guess what? We know our mamas just like they know us. I don't know, why the hell y'all think just because you don't say nothing, we don't know?
Can I say something? So we were separated for 5 years. 3 out of the 5 years, I asked for no child support. I asked for nothing. He told me, I asked him for money for food. He said, put me on child support. That's what he said.
Man, I don't care. I'm gonna tell you why I don't care. Because there's three sides to every story. Yours isn't the truth. I don't give a shit about who shot John. You said that you want to get back with him. I'm trying to understand why you want to get back with a man that you don't think very highly of.
Because I was told that I'm supposed to stay with one husband until then.
I'm curious about who told you this. Who told you you're supposed to stay with one man, one husband? Because it certainly wasn't your mother, because you said your mother chased every man away with her mouth. So who told you this? And if that was the case, why didn't you practice being a better wife so your husband wouldn't have to leave? You see what I'm saying? Like Kevin said, it's three sides to this whole story. Yours, his, and the truth. You're not telling the truth. You're just telling your part. This is what you always told. And so nobody would look at you. You saying, I told him this and this, and he said, put me on child support. But see, the thing is, we ain't heard nothing about him saying, I'm struggling financially. She just thinks he's struggling financially. Oh, he on the couch. He might just be saving his money. Because y'all women don't understand, you still in the house. You still have the furniture. You still have all this stuff because he wants his kids to be without. He has to go and start all over again. So you think he's supposed to be able to start over his life and give you this money. And on top of that, every other little thing you think you need because you decide you don't want to take your lazy ass out and work. And seeing she might be on some kind of disability. And she might have a mental issue is why she ain't working. See, I would have dug a little deep like, why are you not working? Because these kids got to be in school by now. You see what I'm saying? So something she's just not telling, like, why are you not doing anything but sitting on your ass? Just something. And, you know, it just probably just drove him crazy. Just too much. I mean.
And I believe he may be a piece of crap, but.
Whoa.
Stay with him.
Hold on. Wait a goddamn minute, man. Wait a goddamn minute.
It's hypothetically.
There is no hypothetical. I don't do that over here.
I'm so
sorry. Run that shit on some feminist channel. Don't come call your ex-husband and the man that you created life with a piece of crap.
I'm sorry. I did not mean it.
The internet is forever. What do you think?
I didn't mean it like that. I meant like.
Oh, you meant it in a nice way.
No, I just meant it in like.
Stop.
Have you noticed every time she referenced the dad, she used shame and insults? Each and every time. That's why she went too far this time. Kevin checked her. And she said, oh, no, I mean, what's a hypothetical for shame and insult? And she's so used to doing it. Like I said, her mouth. You're so used to having a trash mouth that you don't even know you're doing it. But you're supposed to be healed, right? Guys walking in their homes every day and putting up with this kind of stuff. Every day. Don't want to go home. They're sitting in their cars or at work going to get a drink before they go home. Stop at somebody's house before they go home. Sitting out in the parking lot before they leave to go. They just got to prepare themselves to go home to hear shit like this. And y'all ladies do it all the freaking time. Except this brother couldn't take it no more. He bounced.
Quickly.
Stop. Stop. When you're in a ditch, stop digging. What do you think it's like to live with you?
Probably not easy. Not fun. Some good stuff, but...
So do you think if you're around somebody who's difficult or not easy to live with, that they have an impact on your psyche?
Of course.
Do you think he doesn't love his boys?
I never said that.
So do you think it bothers him not to be around his sons?
I can't answer that.
Yes, you can, and you will.
Do I think it doesn't bother him that he's not around his sons? Nobody stopping him from being around the
board. Don't ask.
Yes, I'm sure it bothers him. It will bother him.
Okay. Everything we've talked about so far has been about you. You're the chaotic center of all of this. And if the world was balanced, he should have custody of those boys. Prior to 1945, he would have had custody.
I'm not opposed to custody. He asked.
But then you'd be paying child support.
He asked for it at one point in time, and his living situation, he gave it back. He said,
okay, ma'am. Here's the thing. There's always going to be, like I said.
Bottom line, this woman is like most of these single mothers out here that you can't co-parent with the father because you want to call all the shots. You want to be able to say when he can get his hair cut, who can cut his hair, who can be around him, who buying him something, where you at, all this. You want to be able to sit around and call all the shots, but he can't call any shots toward you and what you're doing. So she all got all these reasons why he can't be a father. But she never said why she just don't take the kids over to him to see him. If he's having a situation, he just moved out his house. He doesn't have a good situation, living situation right now. Of course, yeah, the kids have to come back until I get situated. You all think he's going to pop out of there and just move into a new place and all this other stuff off the bat. It doesn't work like that. He's still a human and has to get reset up. But you guys want him to do it ASAP because you still in the house. You still got the furniture. You still got all the stuff here. Now, he could have been an asshole and requested half of the damn furniture and half the stuff. But he's so fed up with you, he don't want nothing to do with you. So you're going to take it out on him with the kid like most of you do. If I don't want to go with you or date you no more, guess what you do? Well, you ain't going to see your kids. That's be the first thing come out your mouth. You ain't going to see your kids. And that shit has been passed down since I was a kid watching women in the fucking hood tell their baby daddies just because they split up, you ain't gonna see your kids. And do everything within her power to make sure this man can't see his kids. That is her new mission in life, is to hide these kids, move these kids around, call the police, start a fight, do whatever she can, simply because he chose not to be with her anymore. He didn't choose not to be a father. He wants to still be a father. But in your eyes, you can't be a father to these kids unless you want to take me on as your woman again. And that's what been generational, like y'all said, curses. These are the curses. It ain't money. It's this behavior that you all have that you think is way things supposed to go, because y'all keep passing it down and down and down, because it's single parent household to the next single parent household to the next single parent households. We're sitting back right now and I'm looking at three generations of single parenthood. And the crazy thing, a lot of them still live in the same house. The mother, the daughter, and now the daughter got kids that got them. Crazy. All of them still live up on the same roof. But that's what we got out here, because we refuse to change. We want to keep going with the same thing and the same thing. And we got more and more young men out here looking like a bunch of feminine lost souls. Screaming and cursing and telling everybody they a man, pulling their pants up, dancing, flexing their hips all over the damn place. That's the new men. But guess where they get it from? Their mom, their aunties. These old ass women up in the house. They keep telling you cute. You a good man. You gonna be a good man. No, he's not. He's gonna be a weak dude that like to fuss and scream to get his way, just like his mama did. This woman gonna ruin them two boys because she can't get her shit together. But that's the story. And we're gonna talk about it another time, because it's your boy and I got to get up out of here. Y'all take care. Hope y'all enjoyed it. It's your boy once again. And I'm up out of here. Peace.